evening, everyone. Hope everyone is doing great. First off, very happy New Year to all of you. Happy 2019. So I want to begin by extending a warm welcome to all of you on behalf of Divya Dhwani School of Music and its director, Srimati Chitra Vaidyanathan. First, a few words about the school and the guru, and then I'd like to take a minute to talk about the inspiration behind such a large undertaking. Divya Dhwani School of Music imparts training in classical Carnatic vocal music and nurtures the love of this fine art form in children and adults who aspire to learn this with devotion and dedication. In doing so, Mrs. Chitra Vaidyanathan hopes to keep alive this unique and rich cultural heritage that has been passed on to her by her gurus. She's an ardent patron of music and has been teaching in Chandler, Arizona for the past 6 years. She hails from a family of musicians. She's been learning Carnatic music since the age of 5 from Srimati Anantalakshmi Venkatraman, who's a senior A top grade artist in Trivandrum. She's currently learning from Vidushi Srimati Sita Narayanan, who's also a senior A top grade artist based out of Chennai. She's very active in organizing music programs in the community. The students of Divya Dhwani sing regularly at temples and other venues in and around the Phoenix Valley. She has several students who have given solo short concerts in various venues and have won accolades for that. One of the first things I had asked Chitra when she first approached me with this was her source of inspiration. What was the sort of the driving force behind taking such a large effort? You're going to be witnessing about 60 odd students perform in this, you know, thematic production. And she told me that for about a year and a half, you know, she's had this burning desire to do something for her school's anniversary event, and she wanted to do this on a mega scale. And she had been brainstorming ideas, several different ideas. And the concept of group singing was, I think she kept thinking about it for a while, but it was reinforced, particularly when we had both the Carnatic Philharmonic Orchestra as well as the Carnatic Epic Choir conducted by the Fine Arts Association of Arizona. So she realized that maybe she can do something along these lines. And the next challenge was obviously to figure out, you know, how to get all her students to participate and sing in unison. And she's worked tirelessly on a theme and then the list of compositions to provide opportunities to all the students and also to keep the audience in mind. The theme that she chose for this afternoon very appropriately is on the Tamil month Margari, which is a month of bhakti and music. So this year Margari began on the 16th of December and ends on January 14th, 2019. The importance of Margari was announced by none other than Lord Krishna himself in Bhagavad Gita when he says, among the 12 months, I am Margari. Margari, also known as Dhanurmasam, is the time where spiritual and music-related activities are on a high. We celebrate festivals related to different gods like Vaikuntha Ekadashi for Lord Vishnu, Arudra Darshan for Lord Shiva, Mandala Puja for Lord Ayyappa, and Hanumat Jayanti. This is also the period where Sampradaya bhajans, Andal's Tirupavai, and Manika Vachakar's Tiruvampave are sung on all days. And this is also the season for religious discourses and music festivals. And this month is actually kept aside for spiritual activities, and as a result, auspicious events and marriages are typically not performed during this period. In this concert, the students will sing in praise of the different gods and goddesses seeking their blessings. At this time, I'd like to extend a warm welcome to our esteemed chief guests for this evening, respected Sri Kiranji of SVK Temple, and Dr. Sudha Chandrasekhar. So at this point, I'd like to request Srimati Chitra to say a few words about her Divya Dhwani school and her Guru Parampara, or the Guru lineage.
Thank you, Narayanan. Can you hear me? Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Namaskaram, and a very good evening to all of you. Thank you all for taking this time to come and attend this event. I hope you will enjoy your evening here with us. First of all, I would like to briefly introduce the Guru Parampara or lineage of Divya Dhwani school. I'm truly blessed to learn with Vidushi Srimati Sita Narayanan, who is the founder of this school. Her Parameshti Gurus, that is Guru's Guru, are all doyens of Carnatic music, like Shemmangudi Srinivas Iyer, Aryakudi Ramanujayyengar, Tiger Varadachari, and Alathur brothers. Each of these great musicians have their distinct bani, that is style, followed by multiple disciples of theirs. Srimati Sita Narayanan's first guru, Sri Vishwanatha Bhagavatar, is the direct disciple of Shemmangudi Srinivas Iyer. She further was learning from Sri Hariharayyar, who is a disciple of Aryakudi Ramanujayyengar. Her late gurus, Dr. S. Ramanathan and Sri Rajagopal Iyer, were disciples of Tiger Varadachari. And finally, Sri Changalpet Ranganathan is a disciple of Alathur brothers. I am truly humbled and blessed to be part of this Guru Parampara. Also, I feel honored to pass on this tradition to my students here. With these few words, I would like to bring on my guru's message to us in a very short video clipping here. Please do watch it. After that, followed by MC, followed by Sri Narayana. Thank you.
Samarambha Shankaracharya Madhyama Asmadacharya Paryanta Vande Guru Parampara. My best wishes and blessings to all the students of Divya Dhwani, Phoenix, USA. My memory takes me back to 80s when we started the School of Carnatic Music, Divya Dhwani, in Chennai, India. In an area which was devoid of Carnatic music and music schools, this move of ours to establish a school was welcomed very enthusiastically by the local residents, parents and students. We used to have every month one concert by veteran musicians and also upcoming musicians, because we thought the students should have live music to hear once a month. After the concert, there was very lively discussions and interactions which was really liked by all the students and participants. There were lecture demonstrations also. These helped to create an awareness about music in that area. We used to have our annual day celebrations in a very great way. All the parents, students and the community helped us a lot. Every student was given the opportunity to present one song with violin and mridangam support. All the violin vidwans, mridanga vidwans, vidwans and vidushis gave us spontaneous support. This annual day celebration used to last for 6 hours. I am very happy to know that Divya Dhwani Phoenix is planning the annual day celebrations in December. I also saw the list. You are very capable and hardworking teacher. Chitra Vaidyanathan has prepared a very good list which has variety and lot of imagination, and she has put in a lot of hard work in arranging that list. My best wishes and blessings for the success of this function. I would like to offer a few suggestions. Please practice daily for at least 15 minutes. I know as school going children, all of you are very busy with studies, exams, projects, etc. That is why I suggested only 15 minutes of practice every day. During weekends, you can take this to half an hour or 1 hour. Practice makes perfect Carnatic music. And also, it helps to strengthen your voice, builds a lot of confidence in you. And the practice will help you to learn Manodharma Sangeetam very easily. With practice, Raga, Singing, Niraval, Kalpanaswaram, they all become very easy. In today's world, the communication technology is growing by leaps and bounds. Anything, kacheri, concert, lecture demonstrations, anything happening in music academy or any other big sabhas in Chennai, reaches the shores of America in a matter of minutes. Please listen to a lot of concerts. Music is not just what the teacher teaches and you repeat it after her. Music is also lot of learning other people's music. It's called Kelvi Gyanam. Please listen to veteran, old age, old time musicians, which will help you. It will help you to present Manodharma Sangeetam very well. With these few words, I would like to wish all of you, your parents, your teacher and your school, a very good future and all the very best. God bless you.
Check. Just get a couple of housekeeping items out of the way. If you can please switch off your cell phones or put it in vibrate mode at this time, we'd greatly appreciate it. We'll start the program with a prayer on Goddess Saraswati. Sharade Karunanide in the Ragam Hamir Kalyani, set to Misra Chapu Talam, composed by Sri Chandrasekhara Bharati. In the Pallavi, he says, O Mother Sharada, treasure of all mercy, protect all the people always. You, whose holy benign grace sung by the Vedas, the demigods, and the human beings reverberates all over the quarters. Sharade Karunanide in Hamir Kalyani. Thank you. The next piece is a Rupaka Thala Mala, rendition of a series of short Geetams invoking gods and goddesses. Gananatha and Maya Malavagala, composed by Ponnaya Pillai, followed by Kundagaura, very popular Geetam, in Ragam Malahari, composed by Sri Purandaradasa, and followed by Alankaram Sahitya. Notaswaram. The Notaswara compositions are a set of 39 compositions in Carnatic classical music composed by Sri Muthuswami Dikshitar, who was one of the three early composers celebrated as the Trinity of Carnatic music. Their notables as interaction between the East and West during company rule, being based on Western sources, mostly simple melodies, inspired by Scottish and Irish tunes. They're all composed with Sanskrit lyrics in the Western C major scale, whose pitch intervals correspond to that of the Shankarabharanam Ragam scale in Carnatic music. This Notaswaram that you're going to listen to is based on Shankarabharanam as well. Ekatalam, first on Chatushra Nadai and then followed by Tisra Nadai. And this composition was created by Sri Neveli Santana Gopal.
Take a mop, but I need some of the body.
The next piece is a Todaya Mangalam Ragamalika. Todaya Mangalam is a set of compositions composed by saints Bhadradri Ramadasa, Swami Sri Annamacharya, and Sri Vijayagopala Swamigad, and compiled like a garland by Marudanallur Sadguru Swamigad. The songs in Todaya Mangalam are in praise of Lord Rama, Lord Krishna, and Lord Srinivasa, and composed in Sanskrit and Telugu in Gana Ragas like Natai, Arabi, Madhyamavati, Saveri, and Pantavarali. It is sung as Avana Kirtanam, or songs to welcome the Lord with Mangalam, in the beginning of Sampradaya Bhajan. It is believed that Todaya Mangalam has purifying and auspicious effect. Thus, it is necessary to sing it to provide a pure devotional atmosphere for a successful performance.
Yeah.
I feel like I need to take a break after that. Good job, guys. The next piece is a composition of Maharaja Swati Thirunal in the Ragam Kuntalavarali set to Kanda Chapu Thalam. Bogindra Shayanam, Purukushala Dayanam, Purusham Shashvatam Kalaye. That is the Pallavi of this composition. And in it he says, I prostrate Kalaye before the immortal Lord, Purusham Shashvatam, who reclines on the serpent king, Bogindra Shayanam, the bestower of prosperity to the Puru dynasty, Purukushala Dayanam. And in the Anupallavi, he says, O Padmanabha, your feet are worshipped by Brahma, Shiva, Indra, and other celestials. Bogindra Shayanam, composition of Maharaja Swati Thirunal. Thank you. How about the accompanying artists or instrumentalists? Let's hear a round of applause. I'd like to do a simple artist introduction now. On Mridangam, we have Sri Vaidyanathan Krishnamurthy, who is a disciple of Thiruvayyar Sri V. Gurumurthy, who is a direct disciple of the Mridangam maestro Parani Subramanyam Pillai. Vaidhi, as he is known to all of us, has played in AIR Chennai and major sabhas in Chennai and Bangalore, and has accompanied a number of senior musicians. He's also been part of the organizing committee of the BTM Cultural Academy in Bangalore. Sri Vaidhi Krishnamurthy. Also on Mridangam, we have Sri Mayavaram Shiva, who learns from Guru Padma Vibhushan Sangeeta Kalanidhi Umayalapuram Sri K. Shivaraman. His lessons started back in 1995, and he has been performing since 2003. He has performed at the Music Academy, Mylapore Fine Arts Club, Nungamakkam Cultural Academy, Bharat Kalachar, and various other prestigious institutions in and around Chennai. He was adjudged as one of the top 10 performing artists by VDS Arts Academy in the year 2006. He has won various prizes in Mridangam competitions conducted by Music Academy, Tamil Isai Sangam, Mylapore Fine Arts, etc. He's been performing in the US since 2007 and as an accompanying artist for music and dance programs. Sri Mayavaram Shiva. On Kanjira, we have Sri Mahesh Subramanyam, who started learning Mridangam at the age of 8 under Vidwan Sri Thiruvidai Maradur S. Shankaran. I knew I was going to mess it up. He had his first performance at the age of 12 and continued to receive advanced training from Sri Shankaran with a scholarship from the central government of India. He continues to learn the nuances of Indian classical music and percussion under Sangeeta Kalacharya Vidwan Sri Guruvayur Durai. He has also undergone training on the Kanjira from Vidwan late Sri Mayavaram Somasundaram. Mahesh has had the privilege of performing with eminent artists both in India and in the US. He has also toured extensively as part of the fusion music brand Sandeep and Friends. Sri Mahesh Subramanyam. On Veena, we have Srimati Vasumati Narayanan, who started learning Veena at a young age from her mother, Srimati Saroja Srinivasan, and later took advanced lessons from Srimati Kamala Vishwanathan. In India, she was a regular performer in the All India Radio and at sabhas like VDS Arts Academy and YACM. In the US, she has played in music enrichment programs organized by universities and has given multiple solo concerts. She has performed at the Musical Instrument Museum, MIM, in Scottsdale. Last year, she collaborated with the Sitar School for a Jugalbandi program. She also provides Veena accompaniment for dance and music programs. She's thankful to her gurus and family for their blessings and support. Srimati Vasumati Narayanan. Also on Veena, we have Srimati Vasudha Surya Narayana Pappu, who belongs to the Vijayanagara Sampradaya of Veena playing. Hailing from a family of eminent Vainikas, Vasudha belongs to the third generation of descendants carrying the Sampradaya. Srimati Vasudha has undergone intense training with her mother, Srimati Bandi Sri Lakshmi Garu, from an early age and is currently fine-tuning her skills under the tutelage of Srimati Mambalam Chitra Garu. Vasudha has established Sri Chakra School of Music in the valley and is imparting this fine tradition of Vijayanagara Sampradaya of Veena playing to many. Srimati Vasudha. On violin, we have Sri Ganesh Subramanyam, who is a postdoctoral research scholar at the Department of Physics at ASU. Ganesh Subramaniam started learning violin under Sri Guru Ramesh, who is a disciple of Sangeetha Kalanidhi violin maestro Sri M. Chandrasekharan. His musical education progressed for 5 years under Sri Guru Ramesh. Since then, Ganesh has had the opportunity to participate and perform in concerts, both during his undergrad and grad school days. He also composes music for thematic dance dramas, a skill he honed during his undergrad days. Incidentally, his contribution in this area can be seen in a production by ASU's Pick McKay and Swarajati on February 2nd, 2019, less than a month from now, titled Pancha Tattva, involving several students from ASU. Sri Ganesh Subramaniam. On flute, we have Sri Ankit Raman, who started learning Carnatic flute at the age of 9 from Professor K.R. Subramaniam, who's a senior disciple of Carnatic flute legend Sri N. Ramani. He had the privilege of learning from the legend Sri Ramani himself over 2 summers. He continues to learn from Srimati Bhagya Lakshmi, another senior disciple of Sri N. Ramani. Ankit also learns Carnatic saxophone from Sri G. Ramanathan, a senior disciple of saxophone legend Sri Kadri Gopalnath. He performed in his Arangetram in the year 2016. Ankit continues to accompany Phoenix Valley musicians and is very interested in different genres of music and is presently a self-taught guitar player. While exploring different musical genres and instruments, he hopes to use his musicality for youth causes. Sri Ankit Raman. The next composition is on Ragam Abogi, composed by Sri Papanasam Shivan, Nek Kurugi. This will be preceded by a Kandar Alankaram, a small Virittam.
Thank you. Da da da.
The next piece is a Thirupugal, a funny incident that I'd like to share with you. This happened a few weeks ago when Chitra first approached me to do this job as MC. One of the first things I had requested from her was to get a list of songs even before I received all the audio recordings of all the pieces. And, you know, she had written Nekkurugi and Abogi composition, Papanasan Shivan. And the next piece was Thirupugal, Shanmuka Priya, Kokila Priya. So I looked at it and I immediately texted her and I said, I think you have a typo, because I think most of you have heard of Shanmuga Priya. It's a really popular ragam. And I'm sure some of you have heard of Kokila Priya as well. It's a fairly popular ragam. So then I said, is it a raga malika? And then she texted me back and said, no, Kokila Priya is actually the thalam associated with this Thirupugal. I'd never heard of the thalam Kokila Priya. So I've written up a few descriptions on, in general, what thalams are, and in particular, Kokila Priya. So Carnatic music uses various classifications of thalams. Chapu thalams, 4 in number. Suladi Sapta Thalam, 35 in number. Chanda Thalam, 108 in number. And Melakarta Thalams, 72 in number. Typically, we only see Chapu Thalams and Suladi Sapta Thalams in practice today. And mostly Anudratams, Dhritam, and Lagu Angas are in use. The Chanda Thalam has additional Angas like Guru, Plutam, and Kakapadam, in addition to the Lagu, Dhritam, and Anudhritam. Thirupugal is composed in the Chandam style, which means setting the verses in meter, conforming to beats or rhythm. Varying rhythms were built into the compositions in a way that every song has a distinct tala or time measure. Chanda Thalam is very suitable for rendering Thirupugal compositions. This Thirupugal rendition is in the Ragam Shanmuga Priya and set to the Thalam Kokila Priya, which has one Guru, Lagu, and Plutam. This specific Thalam and Ragam for this Thirupugal was composed by Vidwan Sri P.K. Rajagopal Iyer. The participants will demonstrate this Thalam once before they proceed to render this Thirupugal.
Thank you.
Next we have the 21st Thiruppavai, Aandaal's Thiruppavai, Etra Kalangal Edirpongi Meedalippa in the Ragam Nadanamakriya. Thank you. The next piece is a Jatiswaram in the Ragam Kannada, Adi Thalam. A Jatiswaram is a pure dance presentation, devoid of any abhinaya emotions, in which intricate sequences are fused with repetitive musical notes. The dance deals with the execution of adavus, basic steps, and mudras, hand gestures, combined in definite groups. Jatiswaram in Ragam Kannada, Adi Thalam. The concluding piece is Nagumomu in the Ragam Madhyamavati, followed by a Mangalam. that was the concluding piece. Just another round of applause for all the participants. The accompanying artists, instrumentalists. And the Guru, Srimati Chitra Vaidyanathan.